Mindfulness is really the practice of being aware of what's going on in the moment. Some people add, you know, without judging it, so just really observing. And then the practice of meditation is a more, you know, kind of structured, disciplined practice, often with some kind of an anchor where you're resting attention, the breath, a word, something like that.
In some specific conditions, the evidence is a little bit stronger on the effects of mindfulness meditation. And those are depression, anxiety, and chronic pain. The idea behind mindfulness-based cognitive therapy is that by training people in mindfulness meditation, we increase their capacity for interoception and for being able to listen to their body, so to speak, and to drop in the body. And that will actually help them disengage from this cognitive rumination with negative thoughts about the self. We're testing this hypothesis in the brain by looking at the brain networks that are involved and having people do specific tasks in the scanner to test if they engage in these tasks differently after having received the mindfulness training. The purpose of this research is to find out the mechanisms of mindfulness training in the brain, and from that information, hopefully make some changes to the intervention that take those mechanisms into account. For example, doing more of certain types of practices if we think these are the ones that are key, and perhaps doing less of other aspects of the mindfulness training if science finds that these elements don't actually have so much of an impact.
I think you kind of have this daily practice so that as you go about your day, you're able to be mindful and present, or notice when you're not, because nobody does it 100%.